They thought he was a prophet, or a teacher, or a sage, a disputed man of history, refining Jewish laws. He introduced new principles beyond his ancient age. They said that later he became a martyr for the cause. His death, by human logic, should have put to death his might. His words would just be artifacts and relics from the past. They murdered him, and later he was buried out of sight. They thought they crushed his influence, but that thought did not last. They reasoned and excluded one important major fact. This ancient man not only died, but also lives again. Yet they have tried to hide this and his other mighty acts. Although they try to cover up those facts, the truth remains. To them, he was another man they could not understand. He was a strange, wise prophet, and his words were very odd. He lived and walked among them, teaching in their distant land. To them, he was a sage or prophet, certainly not God. But still, this man was so much more than all they ever thought. The Lord of all creation lived and walked upon this earth, and he became a human. They rejected him as God, and yet he was the holy God who came to us by birth. He lived and breathed the air we breathe and walked upon this land. His mission was to seek and save the lost and weary souls. His death upon a wooden cross, they could not understand. But through his death, now millions can come and be made whole. He chose to take this path of pain because he wants to save and reconcile souls to God if they would just believe. For he has also conquered death and rose up from the grave. And he brings healing, grace, and peace to all who would receive. And so, he is much more than man. He is a mighty king who made himself to be a man, to set all captives free. Though he had all dominion, reigning over everything, he chose to take the path he took to ransom souls like me. To them, he was a prophet, or a teacher, or a sage. To me, he is a loving God who heard my silent cries. The Alpha and Omega, he will reign from age to age. My Maker, Savior, Lord, and God, his name is Jesus Christ. And Jesus Christ, though he was in the form of God, did not count equality with God a thing to be grasped, but emptied himself by taking the form of a servant, being born in the likeness of men, and being found in human form, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God has highly exalted him and bestowed on him the name that is above every name, so that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen.